Look, aren't you lucky? You're getting a second presentation today.
Yeah.
Whoa!
So,
was it possible?
Stefan, yeah. Calm down. Lady, put the bra away. Stefan's going to talk to us about Haiku Depot.
Yes, indeed. And I'm terribly unprepared, as always. Of course, as the true coder, I rather implemented a last-minute feature than to prepare actual slides. So my presentation is about Haiku Depot and about a web application platform that is providing the back-end services. And most people don't know about or don't know a whole lot about it yet. And they don't know the potential and the vision that's behind it. Most of you probably know about package management and that we have it in Haiku, and it's a really nice technical infrastructure. And I always thought the next step would be to provide this software universe to users in which they can discover software. And thinking even further, it also provides a infrastructure for testing software, for migrating it from a bleeding edge repository into a testing stage repository, into a repository which end users see and which contains hopefully only stable software. And this system, of course, needs a platform for collaboration where users which are interested in testing software can rate packages and say, all right, it runs for me, it runs stable. We can migrate this package. And of course, this package might have dependencies to other packages which are not yet rated stable. So there needs to be a filter which maybe migrates a set of packages as a whole into the stable channel. And this is the sort of vision for the Haiku Depot web application, to provide this platform. Of course, there's lots of things still missing. We're not there yet, but Andrew Lindsay from New Zealand has made great progress on this web application. It's mostly written in Java and runs on Tomcat, right? It's an application server. And yeah, I can show you the current implementation, the interface on the web. It's actually live at depot-haiku-os.org. Whoops.
Is that one of the new TLDs?
If not now, then
so,
we should get a couple of minions at the bank.
There you see the interface of the web application. And what it does, at first it might look like a tool to discover the packages, right? But that's not really what it is about. It does show you different architectures and the packages available. But the real fun is when you log in. And I'm going to log in with my administrative account. Oh no, actually I'm not. I'm going to show you what you see if you don't log in first. Let's see this package right here, bshare. If you click it, you can see the information that's in the actual
Internet.
Yeah.
Internet. Okay. So what you see is information which is contained in the actual package files, which is the package title, of course, the package summary, package description, and some other stuff, like architecture and stuff. But one purpose for the web application is to extend the information about packages, to decorate it with more information, with translations of summary and description, with screenshots, icons, and user ratings. And you see there's a rating right there. And also the categories are not available inside the package files. This is all decorated by, with the web app. And if you're just a regular user, you see this interface. But if you log in, hopefully I remembered my password correctly. Then you see a lot more which you can do. You can see I can actually edit the icon. I should have switched this to English, right? Wait. Makes more sense. Okay, you can edit the icon, you can edit screenshots, you can edit localizations, you can edit prominence, which is a feature that we are going to use to curate packages, so that besides a good user rating, there's also like this editor's choice features, which you see in other application stores, where it shows you prominent packages that users might want to install. And this is just another data source. So maybe later on in Haiku Depot, the vision is that you would open Haiku Depot and you see packages that might interest you most. It might be depend on what kind of packages you installed in the past, on user ratings, and on these on this prominence setting. And categories, of course, which is already set for this package. You can see that it doesn't have an icon. I can just upload this icon. How would I do that? I have this package installed. And if I go to Haiku Iconomatic, I can just open B-Share. And save me some icons. I export this as HVIF file, which is the native Haiku icons. Did I already do that? Man, just a second. I did it for B-Share. I can skip this part. Why does it not? So I can choose the B-Share icon. But it's the wrong size. So let's do that again. For the web application, because it doesn't. The web application actually has a part where it does parse native Haiku packages. So it synchronizes with the official repositories that we have, which is the Haiku and the Haiku ports repository, and it pulls information and synchronizes fully automatic. With when there are updates to Haiku ports, the web application will know about it and it can pull the information directly from the package files. The package files don't contain icons. They do in the form that they have an application inside it which might have an icon, but the how would the there might be multiple files with icons in there, so which one is the one that's supposed to be used?
Why don't show them all and let the editor pick?
Yeah. You have one as 64.
Yeah, that's the I want the. The 16 one, yeah.
Why upload bitmaps and not SVG?
We have the native vector icon format already.
For the web interface, why not use SVG instead?
We use the native Haiku icons because Haiku Depot, the desktop application, pulls.
The PNG file you're uploading, why not instead use SVG?
We could, of course.
Yeah, because then you. If you can close the window. Just move it to the side. because we had upload fields for different sizes, you could get rid of this if you just upload an SVG, because all our icons are vector graphics anyway.
Well, yes, but actually the 16 by 16 and the 32 by 32 icons might actually differ. The native icon format supports a level of detail, and so that means that...
And why not just extract them automatically from the native icon?
Because then the web application would have to implement in Java what is already available in...
Well, we could just write a small C++ to which just converts...
Yeah, sure.
Andrew,
do you think this is the most important aspect of IT Depot? I mean, let's prioritize.
I'm storing the SpeeShare icon now, and you can see that it has the icon now. And the nice thing is that in Haiku repo. I have to click install packages. It doesn't have the icon yet, and even when I update, it won't work because there is caching. And if I delete the cache, then it will work. I have this folder already open with the
metadata.
Yeah. So let's delete the cache file and update, and then it should pull the new icon. And if you click a package, you already know that part maybe. You see information which is this comes directly from the package file, from the package kit. And if the web application has a native language description, an already translated description, then it will pull that as well. I have done that for WonderBrush. So if I click WonderBrush, I get it all in German. So as you see, you also get... I specifically disabled all notifications. Let's try that again. Notifications. Hey! It's not permanent or what? Anyway. Who implemented that? So you get the native descriptions in the web app. You can see that you can also do localizations like this. If you go here, and then you can translate. You see the English translations on the side, which is from the package file, and then you can input the native translation. And the idea is that that this will be a platform for people to collaborate from the community. So someone who is not a developer can contribute translations, just like it works for translating applications in Haiku. Have this separate web tool what we have for translations, and this would be the tool to translate package descriptions. And it's a great way for people to collaborate. And there's, of course, also screenshots which you can upload, and we just upload PNG files. And all these features, all these actions you can take on a package in the web app is managed by permissions. So there's a dedicated, customized permission system which is just for this task to facilitate the situation that maybe if you think further into the future of people rating packages as stable or not stable, you might have a reputation of being good with certain software. Maybe you're the maintainer of the package and you have the most knowledge about it, so you should maybe be the only one who rates it or be able to migrate it from the testing channel to the stable channel. So this would be a special permission of your account to be able to migrate that specific package, maybe. So this is just how I thought it should work in the end. And let's see another feature of Haiku Depot. you can rate packages. This is what you need to account for. You see there's the new thing up here which tells you that you're logged in. There's a new feature called logging in. I should probably switch to English. Yeah, you can log in as your user. You can create a user account directly on the website, or you can create an account in Heiko Depot. And yeah, this is how you would do it. And then when you do that, let's try, or maybe oh, I messed it up. Okay, provide an email address, because if you provide an email address, you can reset your password later on. So always do that. If you don't, you get a warning. And you can, of course, specify your preferred language. That will have a consequence in the web application later on. And I have to do a complex calculation now.
39?
No. That will be 31, right? Am I right? Okay. Now if I now create an account, I get a warning that I should supply an email address. I can, of course, ignore that warning. And now I am already logged in as that account. Heiko Depot will store my password for me in the system keychain, so I don't have to remember that always. And now I can rate packages. I can give my rating. I can also rate the stability. Document?
That's interesting.
There was a recent update to the Poodle translations, so maybe something went wrong there. Oh no, make an English rating. And yeah, now it is successfully uploaded. So if I'm back into the web application. Oh, there it is. If I go into the WonderBrush thing, you see that there is no. Oh, yeah, here, and also a really awesome map. There it is. So, like that. And if you're back into WonderBrush, I'm not sure if it does that. Yeah, does it not? It doesn't pull. Yeah, it's cached. It doesn't pull the information. It knows that it's already pulled. So if I have to quit it and reload it, it probably should.
What's the cache?
No, it doesn't cache the actual the specific information that you only get when you view the package. It only caches what's in the list view. So so there it is. Okay, yeah, that's maybe an overview about what's planned for this whole software universe for Heiko. And what I'm really hoping is that people start, instead of, let's do it a different way. By accident, I found out that there's already people publishing their 40, 50 plus Heiko native packages on their own websites, which probably nobody knows about. I just found it by pure accident on Google. And I thought, wow, this awesome site, all this work that worked into it, that went into it, but nobody knows about it. So we should really have people join in Heiko ports, maybe separate Heiko ports into two different projects, the actual porting project and like the software universe type of project where native applications are hosted. and have one repository for that, maybe call it Heiko Universe instead of Heiko Ports, and have all these people collaborate on one repository. There's other examples of people using the possibility to publish actual repositories, so that which you can add in the package manager. So that's nice as well, but people need to know about it. So if they don't know about it, if they don't know how to use the command line to add depots, maybe it's added in Heiko Depot as well to add repositories. We could at least do something in the web application to pull information, pull packages from different repository sources, so that at least the platform could be used to translate packages and provide screenshots and all that. But again, people need to actually add the repositories to discover the software. So it would be better to have everything in one software universe. So that's what I'm hoping, that people understand they have this great platform which is in development. There's great things planned for it. So we should all use it and concentrate our efforts on that. All right, thank you very much. If there's questions, now would be the time.
Yeah. How can we upload some new packages through Heiko Ports?
Yeah, this all works through Heiko Ports at the moment. Yeah. Yeah. It all magically appears in the web app. You don't have to do that again. So if you upload to Heiko Ports, that's all you need to do, and it appears. Good question. It would be nice to have a separate package title, which should probably be translatable as well, because some softwares benefits from a translation, some others just a title, and it's always a question of what to put into the actual package, and what to leave separate in the web application. So I know that translations are planned to be moved elsewhere, like, so that you get them on the command line as well. The other possibility would be to change the command line package manager to also pull information from the web app, but maybe that's not the best idea. Yeah, that's the package title. Then we need the package size, which is probably a good candidate for putting in the actual format, or putting in the repository. And yeah, this can be extended in all kinds of ways. Other questions?
Just, it says in the search thing WRN, but why is that showing on both entries?
I'm pretty sure that the B share has somewhere the WON in its description or its summary or whatever. So I can't actually highlight this. It should highlight the search terms here, but
won't have to take.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah. So,
so
that's
if you put D in that, then it'll
it should disappear. Yeah, so, I went to click here.
Just a small question. I don't see anywhere in the list the package size. So if I have 20 megabytes space and I like to install like 200 megabytes big application, is there any check for that?
No, at the moment this application, this information is not yet available with the package kit. So that would be one thing that's planned to be added. So I think that there's two sources of data. There's the actual package files, and then there's a repository. And I think the repository would be the best place to put the package size, because I don't think it makes much sense to have it in the package. But what you want is you want the size without actually downloading the package, right? So you want it beforehand, so it should be in the repository. And yeah, that's just a matter of extending the package kit API to also provide the size. Other questions? Okay, then. Thank you very much.